Hello everyone, I'm Frank Panofen, I'm the Marketing Manager at Particle Measuring Systems, and I would like to talk to you about the new EU GMP Annex 1, the draft revision number 12, which is out for comment since a few days. My special focus will be today on alternative micromethods, because with my long experience on these microbiological methods, I'm reviewing what is inside and understanding the consequences of the sentences and the regulatory position displayed in this annex. I would like to disclaim at the beginning that this presentation is a personal opinion derived from different colleagues from within Particle Measuring System, and this has no legal relevance, so you cannot use this to defend a regulatory position, but of course you can use this presentation to understand how the actual position for alternative rapid microbiological systems is in the EU Annex 1. In the chapter 2.1, it is an interesting aspect that the use of appropriate technologies, for example, restricted access barrier system, RAPs, isolators, and robotic systems are mentioned in the same line with rapid microbial testing and monitoring systems. This shows that for monitoring and for understanding the quality of facilities and processes, rapid technologies are becoming more and more important and accepted. The important thing is that the speed of the microbial results becomes important, and especially this speed helps to get qualities better under control and to increase the protection against potential contaminants. Chapters 2.2 and 2.3 comment on the fact that the QRM principles and the science behind it is used to control the potential risk of quality. Generally, the alternative technologies that can be used in micro, or all alternative technologies, are generally covered by the quality risk management approach. That's a very important thing. So risk management and risk assessment should be used to understand whether an alternative technology is really appropriate or not. Of course, you need to then document the rationale and to do a risk assessment on how to, whether it makes sense and whether the data generated by this meets the intent. And this is the other aspect of the alternative methods. The alternative method should meet the intent of this annex. And there is surely a debate whether the intent is clear written. All these evaluations under the quality risk management approach done with rationals and risk assessment should of course be subjected into the so-called contamination control system that is now promoted by the new Annex 1. And of course, as the contamination control system is considered to be subjected to continuous improvement, as well, alternative methods need to be considered under this aspect. Chapter 2.2 is emphasizing that the testing or monitoring of a facility should not exclusively give you the assurance of sterility. That means a vital aspect, and still a vital aspect, and the most important aspect, is that the good design of the facility promotes good quality product. That means quality by design is still the ultimate goal in the manufacturing of sterile goods. Alternative testing or alternative monitoring cannot change this aspect, but of course, rapid results and alternative results are a tool to better understand the process and to improve the design of the process. And that's where alternative methods have their strength as well. When we look into chapter 3.2, all non-conformities should be investigated. For example, for sterility test failures, environmental monitoring, and so on and so forth. So investigations in critical aspects become more and more relevant. The problem here is that every investigation that you're doing has always a very strong impact on time. Traditional microbiological methods typically miss the effect of a smoking gun. You cannot see the effect of microbiological contaminations immediately because you typically have a delay of test results of 3 to 14 or even more days. You will have a very strong effect on previous batches. That means, again, the importance for speed in the result becomes important, and therefore alternative methods are promoted. If we look into chapter 4.33, which handles mainly the qualification of clean rooms, in the notes of the table, you can understand that the qualification of clean rooms with alternative methods is possible. They allow and they accept that alternative methods might be even better. Nonetheless, the justification and the rationale needs to be documented. So you need to really write down why you believe that the method you have chosen is better than the one in the table provided. And this is surely not done and cannot be done without the right risk assessment under the quality risk management approach. A very important aspect, of course, when you go to the environmental monitoring, and here chapter 9 is dedicated only to environmental monitoring, and in chapter 9.28, the adoption of the suitable rapid or automated monitoring systems should be considered to expedite the detection of microbial contamination. So for environmental monitoring, rapid monitoring is absolutely encouraged and explicitly encouraged. Again, the speed is important. There is, at this moment of time, not necessarily a value to automation. Automation does not mean that you have a higher speed. Automation means that you get out of the, that you get the operator out of the influence of the results. That means you get more reliable data, but the speed is the most important aspect. Of course, you cannot get away without the equivalency or superiority of the method, so that this equivalency and superiority is shown, and for this the guidance on validation in EP516 is mandatory, and you will need to follow this guidance here. Finally, in chapter 10.10, there is another aspect for alternative methods, especially on products with short shelf lives. If, for example, on ATMPs or other products with short shelf lives. There is a sentence that shows that for products with short shelf life, the environmental monitoring is not available, and you may use a review of the most recent data, which is for me a bit weird, because instead of using old data, you better should have rapid methods or real-time methods that can help understanding the process immediately. Coming to an end about alternative methods, I would like to draw your attention to our services that we have in our portfolio, and knowing that you may want to implement rapid microbiology, our advisory team, who is with experts from the industry, is available to help you in providing guidances on PQ consultancy, on understanding sample point location, doing risk assessment, and making process improvements. So this is a very important part that may help you in the end to increase the use of rapid technologies, and our expert can really help you to implement them at the right time with the right speed and benefit from them early in the time. Additionally, I would like to draw your attention to our training and education approach. Our advisory team can do trainings and educations as well at your site, but on the other hand, we do have a lot of recorded webinars as well on other topics on Annex 1. You can find them on our webpage, and I hope you will find it useful for implementing new technologies in your facility. I would like to thank you again for listening to this webinar. You can contact me under fpanofen@pmeasuring.com. You can find content at pmeasuring.com, and you may as well want to look and find some other aspects of Annex 1 under pmeasuring.com, where we have recorded other aspects of the new Annex 1 drafts and explaining our view of this new draft.